This video shows how to tune up a TPRC-1505. This is a duplexer, and we're going to tune this particular cavity to show you how a pass reject cavity is tuned, but I thought I'd show you the entire assembly. We'll do another video that shows how to get all of this to work together. But anyway, this one and this one are both set up to receive 155, or pass 155, I should say, and reject 155-600, so 600 kilohertz split. And one antenna here puts things to the transmit frequency here and to the receive frequency here and rejects the alternate frequency. So the transmitter on this side is rejected and the receiver on this side is rejected. So no noise from the transmitter gets to the receiver, and the receiver doesn't see the transmitter signal, so it doesn't get overloaded. This is a TPRC pass reject cavity. It's a 1505, so it's 5-inch cans. This is where the cable comes in and out. I've disconnected the cable from the duplexer so that we can tune one of these at a time. This tunes, as I said, the center frequency, the pass frequency, and then these screws can be loosened to rotate this back and forth for coupling. And the third tuning element is the piston capacitor here, which adjusts the notch frequency. It's in series with the loop that's inside of this cavity. And so you adjust the notch here, you adjust the coupling here, and you use this for the pass tuning on a TPRC. First, we want to find out exactly where we're tuned at the present time. And as you see, this is where the peak is, and here's where the notch is. And I've got the thing set up for 130 megahertz down here to 180 up here with 155 right in the middle. And so that's 130, 140, 150, 160, 170, 180. So it's fairly easy to tell where you are. You can also get an idea of what the bandpass looks like outside of the peak and the notch area of a single TPRC. Doesn't go down very fast in either case. The next thing I want to do is to get a little better resolution. This is not very accurate because there's 600 points across here, so each of these is quite a step. So I'm going to put this, rather than a span of 50 megahertz, which is what we have now, I'm going to go to 5 megahertz. Now we have a lot better situation as far as checking where the tuning's really at. The next thing I'm going to do, I've turned on marker 1 and number 2 here. I'm going to put those on the desired frequencies so that we know what we've got. So number 1 is selected. We'll go 155.000 megahertz for it, which appears to be where it's at, and it's about 1.5 dB down, which is within the specs of this particular unit. Let's go to number 2 here. Now, it's obviously not where it's supposed to be. We want to be there. So let's go 155.600 megahertz. And as you see, we're just a little bit off on the tuning on this notch. So we should probably take care of that. It's down about 27 dB. It should be down around 34, 35 dB. And we'll adjust the frequency to where the notch should be using the tuning tool. Just so. So we got about 35 dB of notch rejection there. So that is how you tune the pass and the notch. However, it looks to me like we're at 155, we're about 1.5 dB. Well, between the two cans, you should be that. Probably, and it looks like it's down the slope a little bit on marker number 1 there. So let's raise that a little bit by tuning the center conductor here. Okay, so what had happened apparently is now I'm more or less where I should be on the loss there. Yeah, but now the notch has moved too, because the notch moves as you tune the center conductor of the cavity. So we'll go back to the tuning capacitor here, the piston, and we'll just tweak that in. So now we have about 0.8 and 33.5 dB on the other, and that's probably good enough for the tuning if you're going to just be tuning this for the duplexer, because you will have to do some touch up when you get to the duplexer itself. However, if this is by itself, you may want to rock back and forth and get it a little better than what I've done here. I've put the return loss bridge in the circuit and normalized it here. The purple line at the top shows you the normalized response. The blue line is the return loss as seen. And I can tune this slightly by rotating the loop a little bit, put that in the very center where I'm at, let's see, it's marker number 3 here, 22 dB, which is good enough. Tighten that down. And save that particular trace, which is number 3. Freeze that. So there we go. We're tuned up better than 20 dB of return loss across the frequency of interest. So now we'll take a look at the previously saved copy of the other cavity in this duplexer. And as you see, we have similar results to what we just finished with. And we have 0.47, and we have 32 dB in the notch, almost 33, and about 18.8, so almost 19 dB on the return loss. So I think we're in the right ballpark with the one that we just did. To summarize, TPRC-1505 is typically used in a duplexer, but can be used standalone. Number 2 that we looked at was the pass coupling and reject tuning elements. Number 3, we found where the duplexer or cavity is presently tuned using a wide span. Then we adjusted the span on number 4 to 5 MHz wide for better resolution and accuracy of frequency. And we set markers to the desired pass and reject frequencies. Number 6, we adjusted the peak and notch using the center screw and the piston cap. And then we checked the return loss and tweaked the notch and the pass and the return loss as necessary to get things to line up as best as we can.